Yeah. It's short here, man.
I'm going to show you one example.
years here, so you can actually see their CEO, the way. Then his team, my team have a interview here as well. So what this company does is to do a prediction using machine learning based on your diseases, track your diseases, or give your diseases based on your condition. So I'm going to change. So this is Singapore. So this is my schedule. Okay, you are using machine learning that is part of the thing that you do.
different thing rationally, but this thing rationally.
Subject available, sets taken by the student, the time, the duration,
cars based on the rules. Okay, based on the rules. So you need to support by the rules, check the condition. Now you have the condition here. And then once you check the condition, if there is any crashing of the car, you need to do the adjustment. So it's so called adaptive change. So you have a four fuel brake. Autonomy, sense the environment, sense the environment, sense the input, import into your engine, adapt to the change. If there is any crash, right, so you have to adjust the car to the schedule. Okay. And eventually, what is the goal? You produce output. The perfect timetable for regular and also the system. Good answer. Where you get the answer? This is also really good. Very good. So look at the second question here. What is intelligent air conditioning system? So before we talk about intelligent air conditioning system, what is the limitation for our air conditioning? Two aspects. Yes, you cannot change the temperature based on the current situation. You have to manually go and adjust. Before that, you have to go there. So we would like to build something that is intelligent, which is able to sense environment and to act properly. But if it warms, then you will release more coolant, make the room cooler, right? So again, you have to draw, because the question is asking, draw and design a simple architecture means that you have to draw something. And illustrate means you have to explain. In fact, you have to explain based on this diagram. Illustrate how agents will work, so you have to explain. So I have a question 2 here. The first thing first, you have to identify your input. The input that may affect the action. For example, room temperature. Room temperature. What else? Factor.
Thank you. working with other devices. Other room devices.
Yeah.
Like open the door is open up, then they talk to people inside it.
Okay, also, yeah. Good answer. Okay, so yeah, very good. You have a number of people, meet the humidity, intensity of light, the room temperature. I think the most relevant is the room temperature. The room temperature is humidity. So we have humidity, so the environment here will be your factor. So you can give some example, humidity, the number of people, the room temperature, the ventilation, sound, I think it's not appropriate in this case, yeah? Okay. Then you sense. How to sense by sensor. What kind of sensor do you have? Maybe thermometer, measure the room temperature. What you measure, what you do? You have to check the action. You have to check the action based on what? Based on the room. You will have a one set of room. If the room temperature may be more than 28, actually, release more coolant. If the temperature is between this and this, you release less. If your temperature is less than 20, you do nothing. Okay, a very good flow. You send this, you check your action, then you release your action, and then check again. Whether is it hot, is it warm, then you continue until it becomes stable. Okay, very good. Thank you. Go then, if you don't take up. Otherwise, you can.